In this video, I will guide you through the Worker's Profile page. To enter the Worker's Profile, you can either click on the worker's name or the eye icon here. If the worker has never connected before, installation instructions will be available as shown in the previous videos. Otherwise, you will see a similar page as mine. In the top left corner of the page, you will find a link to the worker's list, worker's name, and other denotions related to the worker's status. In the top right corner, you will find different action buttons. First is a notification button which opens a drop-down with all the latest activity of your worker. For some systems, you will also be able to see different console errors, such as dropped pool connection or driver errors. Here is a link to the worker's configuration. Here is a ClockTune button, which will show all available ClockTune profiles with an option to select and apply a ClockTune, edit it, or go to the ClockTune page. Here is a link to the profit switch. Here is a switch button, which will open a drop-down with all available config templates with an option to select and apply the config template, and toggle buttons for enabling or disabling CPU mining and profit switch. At the end are buttons for restarting the mining client, rebooting the machine, stop or start mining, and shutting down the machine. The page header is followed by a summary of the worker's mining activity. In this area, you can see daily estimated earnings with included electricity costs if you have set the electricity price in the worker's config and information on power consumption is available. You can also see the number of detected GPUs, maximum temperature, maximum fan speed, and mining efficiency. Mining efficiency is a ratio between accepted and rejected shares and should not be lower than 98%. If it is, you should check your pool or overclocking settings and try to improve efficiency. In the power summary, you can see the total power consumption and power efficiency. Power efficiency is a ratio between hash rate and power consumption. The goal is to have this number as high as possible, but you can only compare power efficiencies within the same mining algorithm. In the last part of the summary, you can see an icon that represents the worker's system or type, mining OS, Windows, or ASIC. Here, you can also see local and remote IPs, system uptime, and the time of the worker's last sync. For some systems, there will be a specification button available, which shows more details about your worker's system specifications. A summary is followed by the mining table, which shows all coins you are currently mining and important mining details. The table is followed by a mining historical chart with data saved every 10 minutes. At the bottom of the chart, you can find filters that allow you to show different time points when a special event has occurred. These points are available only for the last few days. Under the chart, there is a hardware table, which will show you all GPUs or ASIC boards that are available for the worker. Depending on the system and type of your worker, you will be able to see different hardware details, including the temperatures and the fan speeds. The hardware table will also allow you to overclock or undervolt your GPUs on the go for each card separately or all at once. Please note that if you are overclocking your rig from the worker's profile, a new ClockTune profile will be created. Under the hardware table, there is a historical chart of fan speeds and temperatures with the hot and very hot limits that you can set in the worker's config. If you have a profit switch set up, you will also be able to see the current state of all the coins included in the profit switch. To quickly switch to the previous or next worker, you can press left or right arrows on your keyboard, or click on the links at the very bottom of this page.